Hello everyone, welcome to History and Culture. When people mention an emperor, many immediately think of someone enjoying great wealth and luxury. With a harem of concubines and absolute power in hand. However, as one of the most famous emperors of the Qing dynasty, was Emperor Qianlong's day as leisurely and pleasant as the outside world imagines? What was his daily life really like? Was it all about indulgence, or was it filled with responsibilities and pressure? According to historians, the era in which Emperor Qianlong lived was the peak of the Qing dynasty, known as the Prosperous Age of Kangxi and Qianlong. This era represented the dynasty's golden period, and as its ruler, Qianlong bore the heavy responsibility of continuing this legacy of glory. Now, we will take a glimpse into his daily life from his perspective. To understand how this longest-living emperor in history found balance between managing the state's affairs and maintaining his personal well-being. According to historical records, Emperor Qianlong's day began as early as 3 or 4 in the morning, long before sunrise. Compared to modern people's routines, his schedule was highly disciplined. In the early hours of the palace, palace maids and eunuchs were already prepared, waiting outside Qianlong's sleeping quarters. Once they heard the emperor stirring, they swiftly sprang into action to prepare for his morning rituals. Palace maids and eunuchs would light candles, provide him with toiletries, and assist him with shaving and dressing. The entire process was well organized. This early rising habit was not Qianlong's personal choice but was deeply influenced by his father, Emperor Yongzheng. Yongzheng had overworked himself, eventually falling ill from exhaustion and passing away at the age of 58. Aware of the pressures and responsibilities of the throne, Qianlong developed a regular routine from an early age, striving to maintain his health through discipline and self-care, hoping to avoid following in his father's footsteps. This seemingly simple process of waking up actually concealed Qianlong's deep understanding of health and his responsibilities to the nation. As the ruler of an empire, he had to ensure his physical well-being to cope with the heavy workload and governance tasks each day. After finishing his morning grooming, Qianlong would begin his first meal of the day, known as the early meal. The Qing emperor's meals emphasized variety and moderation. Qianlong's early meal usually took place around 6 a.m. Though the dishes were plentiful and diverse, Qianlong ate sparingly. A typical meal for Qianlong consisted of over 20 dishes, but he would only take 2 bites of each. This eating style not only ensured a variety of nutrients but also helped avoid the risks of overeating. He firmly believed that moderation in diet was key to maintaining good health. And this restrained lifestyle allowed him to live long, becoming one of the longest-living emperors of the Qing dynasty. Moreover, Qianlong's food choices were not only driven by health concerns but also by safety considerations. The imperial kitchens were divided into several sections, with the inner kitchen, responsible for the emperor's meals, located near the Hall of Mental Cultivation. This ensured that hot meals could be served to the emperor at any time, while also reducing potential food safety risks. Qianlong's vigilance over his food reflected his great caution and sense of responsibility as a ruler. It is worth noting that as the emperor, Qianlong faced heavy political duties each day. After finishing his early meal, he would promptly arrive at the Hall of Mental Cultivation to begin his busiest period of the day, dealing with state affairs. Emperor Qianlong was not only a ruler with exceptional governance skills but also an extremely diligent worker. Each day, he would review hundreds of memorials to the throne, which covered matters large and small from across the empire. Every decision he made could affect the fate of the nation. Qianlong placed great importance on reading the Shengxuan, sacred instructions. This classic text, passed down from his grandfather, Emperor Kangxi, and his father, Emperor Yongzheng, became a daily essential for Qianlong. He believed that by revisiting these ancestral teachings, he could constantly remind himself of the responsibilities and mission he bore. In his view, The art of governance extended beyond specific policies. It encompassed the moral and spiritual legacy passed down through generations. During the review of memorials, Qianlong would often summon ministers to discuss national policies and issues. Whether it was border conflicts, tax reforms, or improvements to people's livelihoods, every matter required Qianlong's personal attention and decision-making. His full dedication to state affairs allowed the Qing dynasty's politics and economy to remain highly stable and prosperous during his reign. However, the burdens of governing often left Qianlong exhausted. When matters became overwhelming, he would even delay his midday meal until all urgent affairs were addressed. This profound sense of responsibility and work ethic was a key factor in Qianlong's long and successful rule. After finishing the morning state affairs, Qianlong's afternoons were usually more relaxed. If there were no pressing matters, he would use this time to cultivate personal interests. As an emperor, Qianlong was not only a ruler but also an individual with a deep artistic pursuit. Historical records show that Qianlong was very fond of writing poetry and painting. Over his lifetime, he composed more than 40,000 poems. While the quality of these poems has been criticized by later generations, the sheer volume of his works reflects his incredible passion for creation. Most of his poems expressed his reflections on life, his feelings about the nation, and his personal thoughts on life. For Qianlong, artistic creation was not only an outlet for his emotions but also a spiritual refuge amidst the demands of governance. In addition to writing poetry and painting, Qianlong had a deep passion for collecting ancient artworks. His famous Sengsetang, Hall of the Three Rarities, was established to house his collection of renowned calligraphic and painting masterpieces. Here, Qianlong often admired the works of ancient artists, sometimes inscribing poems or placing his seal on them. While some at the time viewed this as damaging to the artworks, it was also due to his collection efforts that many precious ancient cultural relics have been preserved to this day. Qianlong's love for and pursuit of art were not limited to his personal creations and collections. He also infused this aesthetic appreciation into palace life through the works of court painters and craftsmen. From palace decorations to everyday items, Qianlong's refined aesthetic taste was reflected throughout. After a busy day, Qianlong's evenings were relatively peaceful. Around 6 or 7 in the evening, he would enjoy a simple dinner, which was often lighter than his breakfast, in line with his belief in moderation and health. He held the view that dinner should not be overly filling, as it might affect sleep and overall well-being. After dinner, Qianlong would use the evening to relax and unwind. Sometimes, he would converse with his close ministers about lighter topics or watch performances in the palace. Despite his busy schedule, Qianlong valued the importance of entertainment in easing stress, which helped him maintain a healthy mental state amidst the heavy responsibilities of governance. Additionally, the nightly companionship of a concubine was an indispensable part of Qianlong's life. As the emperor of the Qing dynasty, Qianlong had many consorts in his harem, and each night, he would select one to accompany him. However, Qianlong's routine was highly disciplined. He would return to the Hall of Mental Cultivation around 8 in the evening to rest, concluding his day. This disciplined lifestyle enabled him to maintain the energy needed to manage the empire's affairs over the long term. Thus, through a detailed look at a day in Qianlong's life, it becomes evident that his life was far from the ease and leisure often imagined. While he enjoyed supreme power and wealth, his daily life was filled with responsibility and pressure. Not only did he have to govern a vast empire, but he also had to maintain his health to cope with the heavy demands of state affairs. Qianlong's lifestyle showcased his deep commitment to self-discipline. From his early rising and moderate diet to his dedication to state affairs and artistic pursuits, Qianlong's disciplined way of life allowed him to successfully rule the Qing dynasty for decades. Although his poetry and artistic tastes have been met with mixed reviews by later generations, there is no denying that his diligence and sense of responsibility contributed to the Qing dynasty's peak under his reign. Some historians suggest that Qianlong inherited his grandfather Emperor Kangxi's benevolent governance philosophy while learning from his father Emperor Yongzheng's lesson of overwork. This unique blend of governance wisdom and lifestyle made Qianlong not only a successful ruler but also a long-lived emperor. This is the History and Culture Channel. Liking and subscribing are the greatest help and support to us. Thank you everyone and see you in the next time.